I beat China all the time. When was the last time you saw a Chevrolet in Tokyo?
Now he's acting like he wants to debate me again. Well, make my day, pal.
I beat China all the time. When was the last time you saw a Chevrolet in Tokyo? When do we beat Mexico at the border? They're laughing at us. They're bringing drugs. They're bringing crime. They're rapists. The big lie, Obamacare.
Donald Trump lost two debates to me in 2020. Since then, he hadn't shown up for debate. Now he's acting like he wants to debate me again. Well, make my day, pal. I'll even do it twice. So let's pick the dates, Donald. I hear you're free on Wednesdays.
Greetings, everyone. Today, I am going to show you how to use this amazing open source application Tencent AI Lab V-Express on Windows. I have prepared this amazing Gradio application for this open source application. It is in development. You see the last commit was yesterday. It is getting better and better every day. And also I am adding new features to my own Gradio application. This application works on both Windows, on Massive Compute, on RAM Pod, and maybe on Kaggle. Kaggle is not ready yet, but the Massive Compute, RAM Pod, and Windows one-click installers are ready. So today I am going to show you how to one-click install and use this application on your computer. It supports bigger than 512 to 512 resolution videos as well. So it is very, very amazing application. This is the best static image into the talking avatar application so far we have. Moreover, this application works with audio input as well, so you don't need a video input to generate talking avatars. It supports both audio input and also video driving input. When you use a driving video input, it tries to also match the talking of the video input as well. However, you don't need a video, it also works with only audio as well. So how we are going to install V-Express? In this post, everything you need is explained step by step. Let's go to the bottom, and in the bottom you will see this attachment download both of the V-Express zip file, and if you want to use the demo images, let's also download it. Move both of the files wherever you want to install. While making a folder name, do not use space character. So do not make it like image2ai like this. You see this has a space character, and in some libraries the paths are not being handled accurately, therefore it is best to use image2ai. You see I have used this underscore instead of the space character. Then let's paste the zip files. Let's extract the zip files. Okay, like this, right click extract, and this is the folder where the files are put. You see we already have Massive Compute and RAM Pod installers. Hopefully I will also make a Kaggle, and I will make another tutorial to show you how to install on those platforms. But today we are going to install for Windows. So all you need to do is just double click this Windows install.bat file. It will install this application into a virtual environment folder, so it will not conflict with any other application that you have. It will be totally isolated. And meanwhile, installation is continuing. You see it is generating virtual environment 3.10. Which requirements you need? You need to have Python 3.10.11. This works best. It works with automatic 11 web UI, conf UI, Cohia, one trainer. This is the best version. You need Git, ffmpeg, CUDA 11.8. This is super important because inside phase and ONNX runtime requires 11.8 and C++ tools. So how you can check them out? Open a CMD like this and type Python, and you should get 3.10.11. If you have multiple Python versions, it will still work as long as you have 3.10.11. How do you check the Git? Just type Git and you have the Git. How do you check ffmpeg? Just type ffmpeg and you see ffmpeg installed. And how do you check CUDA? Just type nvcc --version and it is done. Unfortunately, there is no easy way to check C++ tools. Don't worry, I have a tutorial that shows how to install all of these step by step. Once you install this, you will be able to run all of the open source AI applications. So it is very, very good investment to watch this tutorial and install everything. This is a public tutorial. The link will be in the description of this video as well. So even if you are not my Patreon supporter, you can still watch and follow this tutorial to install all of this. And when we inside the generated folder, we can see the virtual environment folder here. So everything will be installed inside here. If you want to uninstall my installer, just delete this and it will be uninstalled. You see, it is installing inside phase. This will fail if you don't install C++ tools. So it is super important to install C++ tools. And you see, it is getting installed because I already have C++ tools installed. This installer is also going to download some of the models. You see, currently it is downloading. So depending on your internet speed, the installation may take a while. Just patiently wait. And finally, installation has been completed. Do not just close this window yet, because if there is an error, you need to send me entire log of installation. So right click this top of the CMD window and from here edit, select all, then right click, edit, copy, then open a notepad file, save it anywhere you want, and then send me that logs, for example logs, and that's it. Then you can send me this file if there is an error. You don't need to send me, however, let's say there is an error, you can send me. Okay, so now we are ready to use. How we are going to use it? You just need to double click Windows start.bat file and it will start the application. Moreover, I have made some comparison tests. They are inside this zip file, just download it. And inside it, you will see test files and their configuration. So you can look at them to see which configuration is making what kind of differences. So how we are going to use this application? It is pretty straightforward. You just need to upload your static image as an input. You see, these are demo images and videos that we have downloaded like this. Then you can either drop a audio file or video file. All of the formats are supported. Let's try with a video file like this. When you upload video file, there are two options. You see, retarget strategy. If you use fixed phase, it will not use the driving video. So it will use only the audio of this video file. However, if you want to also use the driving video as a face movements, it is best to use offset retarget. There is also description. This is a description from the official authors of the model. So you can also try no retarget if they are same person, or you can try naive retarget. However, I didn't find that naive retarget working better for me, but with your example case, it may work. Then there is target video height and video width. How much VRAM this application is going to use totally depends on your target video width and target video height, and also the duration of your target input. So as you put a longer video or audio file here, it will use more VRAM. It is not like slicing and generating, it is generating as a whole right now, so it will use more VRAM. But don't worry, I am going to make a massive compute tutorial, and there is 48 gigabyte GPU, so you will be able to generate very long videos in the massive compute if your computer is not strong enough. So these are the default settings. There is also reference attention weight, audio attention weight. You can see the description here, just read it. And there is phase focus expansion percent. Now let me show you what does this do. For example, let's try 50% and let's crop this image. This image will be cropped according to the crop width and crop height as you are seeing here. And it will crop the face and it will expand it with the percentage. According to the others, you should really use a focused face. So you see it is focused. So you can try this as a 0%, crop your image. You don't need to click crop, because when you enable auto crop, it will automatically crop your image, and try to animate your image like this. It will work better. As I said, just try and see how it is working. For example, this is 512 to 512. Okay, we are ready. If you don't enable auto crop, it will use your input image as it is. So make sure that your image is accurately cropped and with the accurate dimensions and resolutions. So how much VRAM we are going to use with these settings? You see, currently I am using 7.6 gigabyte. So let's generate the video and see how much time it is going to take and how many frames this input is. You can watch the status in the CMD window. You see how faster it is to find the face in the input video. Why? Because it is finding the face in the every frame of the input video with the CUDA enabled O and an X inside face. So this video is 53 frames. Therefore, this is the length of our video. If it is 30 FPS, it is around 2 seconds. And let's see how much VRAM we will use. Okay. All right, it is starting. It's also displaying the parameters and it is started. So it is using this much VRAM. Let's calculate it. So it is using around 9 GB VRAM right now. If I make this a lower duration, like 30 frames, it will use lesser. If I make it like 100 frames, it will use more. If I make this target video width and height more, it will use more. So this is how it is working. Don't worry, I'm also hopefully going to make a Kaggle notebook for this. So if you don't have a GPU and if you don't want to pay to the cloud providers, you will be able to use this on Kaggle for free. And we got the output. You see, it took around 3 minutes to generate this output on RTX 3090. Depending on your GPU, it will be shorter or longer. So let's play the input video and then the output video.
I beat China all the time. I beat China all the time. I beat China all the time. I beat China all the time.
So instead of offset retarget, if I use fixed face, it will just generate the static head just talking. You can also generate higher resolution. As I said, every generated video will be automatically saved inside outputs folder. Let's open the folder and you see it is named as like this because it is using the input image name and then appending the number. Also, cropped images will be saved here. For cropped images to be saved, you need to click crop image. You can also crop them with different resolution. Let's try crop width 512 and crop height 768. Click crop image. These two options are different. This one is for target video and this one is for cropping image. You see, it is perfectly cropped with the 512 to 768. When I open this image, you will see that it is exactly as 512 to 768. If you need code of this, you can install it and then look at the code because it is there. It is not like hidden. This crop width and this crop height is not same as here. So you need to set them both same if you want it, or you can set them different as well and you can generate different resolution videos. After installation, I suggest you to run it as a default to make sure that it is working. First of all, try with our example video input, example video image. Then once you verify it is working, you can try your different things. So that's it. Hopefully I'm going to make another tutorial to show you how to use this on cloud services if you don't have a GPU, if you have a Mac computer. Moreover, I strongly suggest you to join our Discord channel. The link is here. This is a public link, so if you are not our Patreon member, you can still join to talk with me. Just type SE Courses Discord to the Google and you will get to this page and you will get to this page. You see, we have over 1000 online members and over 7000 members. Hopefully see you in another amazing tutorial. By the way, you can also install this application by using their open source GitHub repository and use it. The link of this repository will be also in the description of the video. Thank you so much for supporting me. Hopefully see you in the future amazing tutorials. Hopefully I'm going to make first tutorial for the Stable Diffusion 3. It is coming soon at the 12th June. Hopefully I will be the first one to make a tutorial for it.